Hello, everybody. Happy January 17th. We're all in the same boat. Everybody's sick with either colds or this second virus going around. We've been nowhere. We just hang out at the house, and that's dangerous.
Yeah.
We were sitting here thinking, what are we going to do? Normally, I do like 10 loads of wash a week. But since Teddy's gone, we're down to one load a month. Let's be honest. Let's be grown-ups here. We all know how it goes. You get up, you put pajamas on just in case the neighbors knock at the door to see if you're alive. You go eat, you go back, take your pajamas off, and watch TV in bed. I mean, that's just the way it is. We felt we were getting in a rut, so we decided we were going to try to figure out some things to do. And one of the things that was bugging us is that washer. It's an expensive washer, and it's just sitting there. It's doing nothing. It's not earning its keep. I'm babysitting my niece's fish, and I noticed one of the tanks is pretty nasty. So what I did was transferred the fish to my washer. I filled it up halfway with cold water. That's really, really important. You got to remember to fill it up with cold water. Hot water doesn't work. I don't think she'll notice that the fish have a little bit different color. I'll blame it on the water. Anyway, we put the fish in the washer, clean the fish tank. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's really important too. Another safety tip. When you fill the tub up, you know, for the washer, unplug it in case a cat bumps the drain button. Anyway, that's what we did. We cleaned the fish tank spotless, and then we put the fish back in the fish tank, and we drained the washer. You might want to, like, do a rinse just in case there's any little scales floating around. So that's what we did with the washer. Now, the dryer was a totally different thing. That project was different. There's no water. Yeah. So he decided he wanted fresh baked bread, and I'm on board with that, but I'm not going for it, you know? So, what to do? Normally, you make the dough, you let it rise, you knead it, you let it rise, you beat it, and then you let it rise and throw it in the oven, right? The dryer eliminates all the nonsense. You get a clean pillowcase, throw some flour, shake it up in there to, you know, line it really good. Put the dough inside the pillowcase, tie that thing a nice knot sucker, you know, but make sure you leave enough room for it to, you know, expand. Throw it in the dryer. Yeah, we found 45 minutes works really well. Yeah, it lets it rise and then it beats it and it's rising and it's beating. And after 45 minutes, we took it out of the pillowcase and threw it in the oven, and we had fresh baked bread. Yeah. So that's what we're doing with our time being locked in the house because everything is closed because we have a moron for a governor. He's not leaving anything at the Murphy house for Easter. I'll divorce him if he does. Anyway, that's what we're doing, and we hope that you're finding ways to amuse yourself. Yes, really, it's so important to unplug the washer while it's got the fish in it. Anyway, we'll talk to you soon again. Hang in there.